Hello everyone. Andrew Seedhouse from Plymouth University introduced my colleague Ian Miller, who is the Regional Director for Traveline South West, and we are the Bill and Ben of passenger transport for Plymouth. What we'd like to do is to give you an overview of one of the projects we've been working on the last year, which came about through some work from Plymouth City Council back in 2012. Councillor Mark Coker, who was the head of transport for Plymouth, organised a whole youth summit with the Youth Parliament for all of the young children within the city to come and understand their transport problems. We had a whole day of workshops, exercises, activities, and a very, very useful panel session with bus companies and other providers looking at the problems that they faced and possible solutions from that. And we came away from that event and thought, well, actually, as a university, we think there's an area we might be able to help here. We have sufficient contacts, we know the right people, why don't we try and work with the local authority to try and find a way forward? So we separately organised with Traveline a session with some young people to take forward one of the challenges that they said was a big problem, which related to accessing information and collating together in a usable form information and data to make their journeys easier. And so at this point, I shall hand over to Ian, who can tell you about what we've actually been doing about it.
Thank you, Andrew. Well, there's a list there of all of the identified problems, or the main ones, but some of the implications from those problems can be solved through providing better and more easily accessible information. So what we wanted to do really was put some power back in the hands of the users to solve these issues for themselves. And as an organisation, my company, SWPD, the company I work for, have had about 15 years of compiling data and using it to help solve transport issues. So really we thought that was a decent place to start from. What we effectively had in Plymouth here was a bit of a market failure, because you had local youth potential bus users who were a bit disenfranchised by what had been going on with changes in the network. And they're really a growth sector, the next generation of users for the operators, and really we think they should be looked after a bit better. They do have a far higher knowledge of sustainable issues and green issues than I ever did when I was at school, for example, but that's probably not too difficult. So we wanted to intervene to make things better, to help simplify planning, help people make connections. There's one of our better transport ministers, John Prescott, indulging in some leisure activity. He got together with Professor David Begg, who's actually a visiting professor for this university in sustainable transport, and he's former chair of the Commission for Integrated Transport. And they got the keys to Chequers off Tony one weekend, and they shut themselves away there. They got some inspiration. Perhaps it was red, perhaps it was malt, I don't know. But they came up with a document called From Workhorse to Thoroughbred. And that was about putting buses at the centre of 21st century urban transport, certainly. And one of their strands was having effective information for people. And that's where Traveline came from. It removed a barrier, or a potential barrier, to use of public transport. And we deliver this information through this company called SWPD, which is really a collaboration between all the local authorities and main bus operators, between Land's End, Portsmouth and Gloucester. The principle is the single source of truth. Professor Codd's data normalisation laws, or one of them, have a single pot of comprehensive, unbiased data, which we can then use for various purposes. And our aims as a company are to list it there, so raising the quality of public transport information and using new technology to get it out on as many platforms as possible. And we're still striving towards the one-stop shop, but we keep trying between us and making little efforts and little moves forward. So we thought we'd drag some other people in. So Andrew, part of Southwest Smart Applications Limited, Swizzle, as part of the university, got some academic help on research and apparating from the university, and also Plymouth City Council, because of their connections with the Youth Parliament, were very much engaged. So, let's put all that together, see where we can get, see what expertise we've got. Well, we decided that an app, a mobile phone app for the youth market, which was very much targeted at Plymouth, would be a good starting point. Base it on current platforms, start with iPhone because that was the most popular one. One principle was it had to be free to the user, and it had to be simple to use. So let's make it intuitive and give some real information to users in an instant. And we felt towards the end of the project that we would certainly like to look at putting some extra ticketing deals for the youth market on it. It is very much a work in process. And we've started with the data position, because without the data, we were nothing. So our data is built up at a local level, it's accurate, it's updated every week. It's backed by good GIS mapping data, and it is certainly comprehensive, and it's supposed to cover all operators. It does cover all operators. Our current app that we have on our website, which is travelinesw.com, has this fella on it, Happy Traveller. We're not brilliant at marketing, but we've come up with a few things. Is based on that good current information. So it has good stop location information. It is a journey planner. It will get you from A to B via a mix of weird and wonderful routes, if there are no straightforward ones. And it will tell you how to walk to and from stops and get to your final destination. So the data it's based on is very good, and it will get you the information. However, what it doesn't do is update you with reality, if you like, what's actually happening now. And an underlying principle of what we're doing was to use real-time information for the new app. And what we've got so far is a beta version, which is out to test with our focus groups. This is a typical focus group, is it?
No, absolutely.
Yeah? Okay. We've got focus groups based on the Youth Parliament for the younger age of the younger end of the age spectrum we're dealing with, and also university focus group to look at the bulk of it. There'll be an open consultation loop. We've got beta versions. They'll be looking at, is it intuitive? Where does it need improving? Does it do everything? What else does it need? We need to fuel the products, and we thought, well, as we're encouraging sustainable travel, maybe we can relax a bit on the obesity problem as well. So we do encourage them to take part. We're going to go live with this app in summer. We thought about a name for a while. We rejected the sort of in-betweeners insults thrown out of the car window as a name for the app. You can look that up on your search engine later. We thought of a local name, like here was a bus too, but thought maybe that wouldn't be applicable once we got going elsewhere. So we came up with Bustopia. So it's something to work with for now. The promotion on the app will be locally concentrated because it's targeted at the Plymouth and Travel to Work area around Plymouth. So it should be easy to push out and easy to let people know what's when it's available. And we'll be assessing the effect that the app has on bus travel and user satisfaction with that travel, and also user satisfaction with the information, which is fairly key KPIs for the local authorities. So all the partners involved in the project will be promoting the availability. What else do we have to do? We certainly have to link through to ticketing products still. We want to actually use it to demonstrate to the market that there is a niche here that they're missing, and they need more products to come through that we can link with. That would be the ideal scenario. We think there is a big latent market that they're not tapping into. We've got a good tie-in now with the university for research and development, and we want to continue with that and expand out to the Android platform first. And what this project has shown us is really that current information, real-time information, is absolutely key to users, that a good partnership with the university and the company will bear some more fruit in the future, and we're certain that intensive local participation is required to solve the local issue. So the proof will be in the pudding over the summer, and have a look at the stand outside and keep tabs on when we release the app. Thank you.